everybody. Happy Friday. As usual, I had a really good conversation last week that I wanted to share with you. A question arose during the conversation that I thought was really profound and a valuable question, and one definitely worth considering. And the question is, the title of this blog, is self-learning and even self-progress, is self-progress linear? In other words, when you see something about yourself that you want to change, or a new habit that you want to establish, or an old habit that you want to get rid of, is that process linear? In other words, do you realize the change that you want to make, start making effort towards that change, and continually progress, continually move forward from the old habit to the new habit? Does it happen like that? And my answer would be, unfortunately, absolutely not. It doesn't work like that. And as frustrating as that is, it's completely logical. Typically, the habit that we're trying to erase and recreate into a new habit, it's been there for years. Some habits have been there for our entire lives. Here's the other thing. Some of the things that we think, some of the ways that we act, some of the paradigms and thought habits that we operate from, have not only been a part of our entire life, but they've typically been a part of our parents' lives also, and maybe even their parents' lives before them. So when we're trying to get rid of one habit and replace it with a new habit, you can see that you're fighting against a lot of stuff, not just the stuff that's in your life, but you're fighting your ancestors' lives as well. You're fighting an age-old paradigm, and typically, it's not only a paradigm that you and your family have held dear, but one that society holds dear. So you and your parents may have decided that it's a paradigm that needs to be switched, but the whole society may still or predominantly think that it's still a good habit or still a good paradigm. So I want you to take heart in the fact that when you're fighting this, you are truly fighting an uphill battle. You're fighting something that is deep-seated and has deep roots within you and has deep roots typically within society. So take heart in that. But first of all, don't go into a change expecting it to happen either overnight or to happen in a linear fashion. It doesn't work like that. It looks more like the graph of a business that has a seasonal commodity. So you're going to see fluctuations, and that's exactly what's going to happen with self-progress. You're going to have times when you're feeling inspired, and you're feeling motivated, and you understand, and you get it, and you have the energy and the wherewithal and the mental abilities to tackle this issue and to apply it to your life. And then the very next day, or maybe even 10 minutes from now, you'll experience a letdown, and you'll struggle, and you'll fall back, and you'll wonder, how did I ever get that? How was I ever there? And furthermore, how will I ever get out of this place that I'm in? Doesn't it always feel like that, or often feel like that, where you're in such a place where you're fighting this habit, you're fighting this thought habit, and it feels like it's going to take an act of God to get you from where you are to where you know you need to be? And sometimes logic isn't enough. Even though you know that where you are isn't a good place, getting to where you need to be, even though you know it's a better place to be, doesn't help you get there sometimes. So I want you to take heart in that. First of all, change your expectation. Self-progress is not linear. It's going to feel like one step forward and 5,000 steps back sometimes. It's going to feel like all your effort and all your work hasn't done you any good. It's going to feel like that. So change your expectations, for one. For two, give yourself grace. At least you're doing something about it. I don't like to bring this up because I don't want to think negatively about mankind, but there are thousands of people out there just like you who are not choosing to do anything about their thought habits and those old paradigms. Even though they have evidence that those old paradigms are no longer working, they're still not choosing to do anything. And bless them, it's out of fear. It's out of fear and not knowing and not having a friend to take them by the hand. So take heart in the fact that you at least have recognized that it's an old thought habit or paradigm that needs to change, and you're trying to change it. and give yourself grace and allow yourself some patience to go through those moments of one step forward and 5,000 steps back. And I'm saying this to myself at the same time too, because I often don't have patience with myself. When I recognize something that needs to change, I'll feel like I've already been here. I have already known that is something I need to change. Why am I back here again? Why isn't it changed and changed for good? I get that. I really do. So keep at it. Keep working at it. I guarantee you that it will get easier, and that those thought habits and patterns and old patterns, that they will start to give way, and you'll start to pick up momentum just like a train out of a train station. You'll start to get it, and you'll start to feel better, and you'll start to feel the effects of your efforts. And at that point, man, there's just no stopping you. And yeah, you'll hit that wall again, and you'll think you've already hit that wall. Wait a minute, how come I'm hitting this wall now when I hit it 5 miles ago? It's okay, that's gonna happen. Just keep plowing through those walls. They're meant to break down under your strength and your will, and you do have what it needs to break them down. So keep going. And in the meantime, grab the hand of one of those people who cannot do this on their own. Grab their hand and take them with you and help them. There are just tons and tons of people in this world need help. Grab somebody's hand who can't do it alone and do it together. Break down those walls together. And not only will you helping someone else make you feel really, really good, it'll help your progress as well. Watching them break down their own walls will help you break down yours with so much more certainty and conviction and strength, I guarantee it. Have a great weekend, and I will see you on Monday.